There is a way the present makes one look back to the past to reappraise what worked and what didn't and what could be done much better. And this brings me to my topic, remembering Nigeria's information managers. I thought of the combative style the country's information is presently being managed and the wailer-hailer binary and wondered if it had always been so. My quest is to remind us the manner of information management we had in the past, our most loved ministers of information since independence, and what we remember them for. Sure enough, there were those who served under the military and those who served in a democracy. Reining your thoughts, I'll return to the military era information ministers in part two. For today, let's take a look at these nine individuals, seven men and two women from 1999 till today. They are Dapo Sarumi, Professor Jerry Gana, Chukwuemeka Chikelu, Frank Nweke Jr., John Odey, Professor Dora Akinyele, Labaran Mako, Patricia Naomi Akwasike, the second woman, and Mr. Lai Muhammad. Nostalgic, right? I thought so too. Salutes to late Chief TOS Benson, Nigeria's first information minister from independence to 1960. Well, Dapo Sarumi, who served from 1999 to 2001, was defeated by Shiwaju Bola Tinubu in the Lagos State gubernatorial elections. The rebirth of FRCN started in his time. Professor Jerry Gana stands tall, a four-time minister overall, who served as information minister under General Sani Abacha in 1994-95, and then 2001-2003 under President Olusegun Obasanjo. We'll remember his media tours of federal government projects across the states, his eloquence, his camaraderie, and passion to ensure national cohesion. You remember MAMSA and then National Orientation Agency? That was Jerry Gana. Chukwuemeka Chikelu served from 2003 to 2005 during the second term of President Obasanjo. There were full protests, there were plane crashes in his time, but he always sided with Nigerians. He was not a government puppet. Frank Nweke Jr. from 2005 to 2007 was one of the most urbane managers of information and youngest cabinet ministers in Nigeria. He had a spat with Professor Wole Soyinka, for which he was massively criticized. His attempts to break the monopoly of DSTV with Zubair's High TV did not quite work back then. And then there was the late John Oga Odey, 2007 to 2008. Brave Professor Dora Nkema Akili served from 2008 to 2010, unforgettable for remarketing and rebranding Nigeria. Remember, good people, great nation. And she defied the system to tell an embarrassed nation the whereabouts of President Musa Yar'Adua at that time. Labaran Mako served between 2010 and 2015 under President Jonathan, a journalist and student union activist. He continued Dora's work and countered opposition endlessly. And then we had Patricia Akwasike, who stayed for only 2 months in 2015, not enough to score her. Barrister Lai Muhammad performed well as an opposition spokesperson, has been minister since 2015. We will remember him for the MBC code controversy, hate speech, fake news, and wanting to foist the anti-social media bill on the nation. You know, back then we had information ministers without addendums. Nowadays we have semi-information ministers in addition to the ministers who deride and abuse the public. Citizens were courted, but nowadays we are to be silenced at all costs. The right to peaceful protest should not be abolished in a democratic government. And yes, we do have a right to criticize the government. To paraphrase Oke Ikechukwu, former aide to former minister Chikelu, personal interventions by government information managers is important and critical for effective communication. However, when such political visibility is overdone, it undermines the information machinery and injures government's credibility. My advocacy is that the country's present information minister should consider these issues and the labor of our past heroes in information management and stem the continuous slide into divisiveness under his watch. 200 million Nigerians cannot be wrong, and the government at the center is perpetually right. Famous or infamous, your legacy stares you in the face. Effective leaders listen.
Wow.